everyone, welcome back. It is Friday Favorites and Flops, and I hope you guys had a wonderful week. I had a great week. Sunday was a little bit crazy. I went to the Lilly Pulitzer collection opening at Target, or reveal at Target, and I honestly went there early because one of my little girls had really bad allergies, and I went to get her medicine like super early in the morning, and I don't live very far from a Target, and we roll up, and I thought, okay, Target opens at 8, we'll be like right there, we're just gonna sit in the car. I got the girls donuts, like a little donut shop right there, so we were just gonna eat our donuts and wait in the car. I see this huge line of people, well not huge, but like a significant line, and I was like, what in the world? What is going on at Target? So we get out and my girls are like, Mommy, why is the big line? Does everyone else need medicine? And I'm like, no, nobody else needs medicine. I ask a couple people and they tell me like what they're there for. I mean, some people were intense. Even the girl from Target came out and said, everyone act like adults or you'll be kicked out, basically. I'm like, whoa, this is gonna go down. So we kind of like all bum rush in, and I picked up a few things. I showed it on my Snapchat, but anyways, one of the things was this headband, and it's just super cute. I got a couple cute, I almost just like donked myself in the face, but I got a couple cute makeup bags. Everything was really cute, bright and springy. I really loved all the patterns. It was nice. A lot of people, I posted on Instagram, a lot of people were like, that looks like stuff from Florida, like when you're on spring break and you're an old lady. There were some people I felt bad. Like tons of people were like taking 5 or 6 of one item, and you know that they're selling that stuff on eBay. That's just ridiculous. I got home and the bag that I bought for $50 was on eBay for $164. Are you kidding me, people? Are you kidding me? You can buy a bag from the Lilly Pulitzer website for the same amount of money. Like, why? I don't understand. So anyways, that happened on Sunday, and the rest of my week was uneventful, but I did have some favorites this week, some oldies but goodies, and then some newer products. So I'm just gonna get in and start off with what I have on my nails. Butter London recently sent out some of their new polishes to some bloggers and vloggers, and they're called the Pat and Shine 10x Nail Lacquer. These things are amazing. They have a ton of different colors. I received 4 different shades, so thank you to Butter London, because I'm just really grateful that I could try them out. But the first color that I had on my nails almost all week was this shade right here, and it's called Shop Girl. It's a beautiful, I would say like nude beige color. I love this shade. It's very nice to have on your nails, just nice and neutral. The thing is, these have an amazing shine on them, almost like they look like gel polish, no top coat, and they're supposed to last for 10 days. This color lasted until I took it off and put on this one. And this one is called Chat Up, and it's just a really nice tealy blue color. So, I love these polishes. They can be found, I think, at Ulta, and you can find them online at Sephora. I will link them down below, but really, really great formula. This was one coat, and it was like full opacity. This was 2 coats, and it was, I could have gotten away with 1 coat. It wasn't streaky at all, but I put on 2 coats just for good measure because it was the first time I was using it. And for some reason, I'm just like, 1 coat is just weird. It's not thick or goopy, but it is a thicker formula than a typical nail polish, but it is just got such a great finish, a great shine, and less on the nails. So these are really great polishes. If you see them out, definitely pick one up and see what you think. Okay, another new product to me is from Estee Lauder. It's this blush, and it's called Lover's Blush, and Pure Color Lover's Blush. Now, my friend Natalie from Flowerbomb31, you guys, if you don't watch her channel, you have to, because she's just, I just love her recommendations. She has the most amazing taste in makeup, and she has been talking about this blush probably since I've been watching her. I've heard her talk so much about this color. It's just that perfect bronzy peach. You can't really put it into, like, it looks like nothing, but when you apply it to your cheeks, it becomes everything. It's just this beautiful peachy bronze shade. I am wearing it right now. It gives your face like a glow, and I don't know, it blends in so well. It's smooth, it has like a subtle shimmer in it. This would be a perfect color even for someone with mature skin who does like a little bit of a sheen but doesn't like shimmer on their cheeks. This is subtle enough to wear. It's the perfect soft peach with bronze and like golden shimmer in it. It's beautiful. I love it, and it's the perfect everyday color because it really does make your face glow and give you that nice peach with the just the glow to it. So really been loving this. Great recommendation from Natalie. So I'm glad I finally picked it up. It's been on my list forever, and I just kept stalling picking it up for some reason. I finally bit the bullet. Okay, another product that is newer to me before I get into my oldies but goodies are these new lip glosses from Lorac. And this is the shade that I cannot get over. It's called Goddess. These are high pigmented glosses. I mean, this is like the perfect mauve, dusty, like lavender shade. I can't even. It's so beautiful. It's what I'm wearing right now. I'm wearing NARS Alagwa. If you can't find NARS Alagwa lip liner, get the Clinique one in Sky Violet, I think it's called. It's beautiful. Or Violet Sky, something like that. Either one of those swatch of the words. It's beautiful, and it's a absolute 100% dupe. So get that one if you can't get your hands on NARS Alagwa. But I'm wearing that lip liner and then just this gloss. It's super pigmented. These smell like candy, and they're just so amazing. Like, let me just show you. It's like this beautiful, I can't get over the color. It's even more like dusty and mauve-y in person. I am obsessed with this color. It's pure cream, there's no shimmer to it. Just a beautiful, beautiful color, and it pairs so nice with that lip liner. Also, another lip liner that's really great that would be, it's not a dupe at all, but it's kind of similar, and it would give a nice similar look, or it would pair really well with this, it's from Jordana, and I think that it's called like something shimmering lilac or something like that. I will insert the name right here because I'm going like, I can't think right now of the name. But it's a really, really beautiful liner that's affordable from the drugstore, and it's a great alternative and would go well with some of your more pinky or dusty mauve glosses. Okay, now my oldies but goodies. I pulled out my Urban Decay Naked 3 palette. This was released and it was like all the craze. I'm talking all the craze. Everyone was doing tutorials on it. Everyone was featuring it. It was like very highly anticipated. And I used it for a while, and then I kind of just put it in the back of my collection. I've only pulled it out periodically, and I really have been diving into it and creating more looks with this week. And the colors that I've had on my eyes, or that I have on my eyes today and I've been wearing a lot of, are these two matte shades in Limit and Nooner. And this is the darker one, Nooner, and Limit is the lighter one. So I have both of these in my crease, and they're just really nice. Again, like dusty mauve shades, perfect transition colors. And then I have this matte color in Strange all over my brow bone, and then I did put it all over my lid like to kind of set my base. I would say it's like a pinky, I don't know, it's a pretty nice matte color, but it does have like a little bit of a pink undertone to it, and it works perfect if you're putting it on your brow bone, and then when whatever your transition is, if you just run that color along the edge where your brow bone shade and your transition shade meet up, it really does a nice job at softening and diffusing that transition shade. It has so many other really beautiful colors, but I've kind of used those a lot, and so I'm trying to use some of the other colors. So this is Trick, and it's another gorgeous color. I'm going back and forth with my hand swatches right now, so you're gonna see everything on both hands. This is a beautiful like rose gold color. So really been enjoying this palette again and creating looks with it. And So another product that I wanted, instead of like a matte shimmer lid, I really wanted some shimmer on my lid today. So I pulled out L'Oreal's Infallible, and I had been using this throughout the week on my inner corners. And today I was like, I'm putting this all over my lid because I was feeling it. And this is just a gorgeous lid shade. It's a beautiful inner corner shade. It's a beautiful highlight shade. This is very similar to Stila's Kitten Eyeshadow. It's just gorgeous. It's almost like a white gold champagne. It just has the most beautiful sheen to it. It's so magical. You could use it as a highlight in your inner corner, and it just is so soft and blends out so beautifully. So I have that in my inner corners and on my lid, and I just love that shade. I always forget how much I love it until I pull it out. Those Infallible eyeshadows are amazing. If you've been wanting to try out some type of, like, they're very similar, not really similar in formula, but they're kind of like Makeup Geek's foiled eyeshadows, which they're coming out with new shades, and I'm pretty sure that I will have those new shades to show you guys and share with you guys, so I can't wait to do more tutorials. But they're very similar to that. I actually think the price point is very much the same though as the Makeup Geek and the L'Oreal Infallible. So if you've been wanting Makeup Geek but you're just not an online orderer, try picking up a couple of those shades. But anyways, I think that those Infallible eyeshadows are really, really nice. I like Amber Rush. I love that color in Iced Latte. So I don't even know if I said that color. It's Iced Latte, and it's just beautiful. But moving along, another favorite that is an oldie. I used to talk about it a ton. It is the Triple Eye Remedy. This is the Eye Duty Triple Remedy from First Aid Beauty. You guys, this is a instant brighten, depuff, and smooth. Safe for sensitive skin. It has a metal tip applicator. This thing is amazing if you have under eye puffiness, or if you have dark circles, you just need a little bit of brightness. I put this on some days when I am wearing no makeup and I just want something under my eyes. Sometimes brightening under your eyes is just like all the difference. You know what I'm saying? So you just look awake, you look alive, it feels smooth and cooling on the eyes. It is a peachy tone. I find I use less concealer when I use this. Let me just get a little bit more. It's so precious. I just don't want to lose it, use it all up. But it has a peachy tone, as you see, and it just feels so nice under the eyes. It's an instant product, but it's also an overtime product. It has caffeine in it, so it shrinks those eye bags, depuffs them. It has that cooling applicator. So instantly it does do something magical to your under eyes, but also it has products in it that over time help with puffiness and brightness. So it's like a two for one, but I don't use it at night. I only use it in the morning. It's one of those products that, because of the tint, because of after you've been sleeping, it just makes you look like you had a ton of sleep. So love that product, and I've had that for a while. A little bit goes a long way. I just put a little bit in the inner corners right here of my eyes. So, and I love it. I love it. It feels so good, and it instantly lifts my eyes. Another oldie but goodie is this mascara. This is from Chanel. You guys, if you've watched my channel, you know that this has been like my love for years and years and years. I've purchased it for many of my friends because I'm like, try this, try this. It's amazing. Mascara is one of those things that is different for a lot of people. I'll tell you what I like about this mascara, and you guys can tell, you guys can maybe use what you like about mascara, what you're looking for in mascara, and decide if it's right for you. I have medium-sized lashes. I wouldn't say my lashes are short. I wouldn't say that they're extremely long, but I think I have decently sized lashes. This is amazing with volume. It's really good with separation. I don't find it gives me spider eyes. The formula is a little bit wet on it. It has a little bit of a wetter formula at first. I would say that this mascara is the best after you've had it open for a month. So if you have this mascara and you find the formula is too wet, don't give up on it. Leave it a little bit cracked maybe overnight, or try it a little bit later, like a month later, and see what you think, because the formula is the prime when it dries out just a little bit. I use it the whole time, but I recently picked up another tube of it when I went to BeautyCon, I believe, back in March. And so I used up the other tube, and I've had like at least, this has probably been repurchased like 4 times. I love it so, so much. It's $30. The reason I wanted to mention it again is because I think Nordstrom is having their mascara buy one or buy two, get one free sale coming up soon. I'll try and find the information on that and leave that below. It's a perfect time to stock up on some of your mascaras that are a little bit more expensive and that you've really wanted to try, but you know, you don't really want to shell out that price. This, it's either buy one, get one free, or buy two, get one free. I'm not quite sure, but I know you do end up getting one free. And the Chanel Le Volume is the mascara to try. It has a synthetic wand. It's not a natural bristle wand, but it doesn't poke at my eyes. The bristles are very, very short on it, and they just really do a great job at getting to my lashes. It, like I said, if you have stubbier lashes or if you have lashes that are difficult to curl, this is a little bit more of a heavy formula that you might find that it will bring your lashes down. It doesn't do that to me, but that has been a complaint that I have heard about this mascara. So I just wanted to put that out there because, and I know I've said this before on my channel, but if I recommend a product to you and it doesn't necessarily work, don't be afraid to say to me like, hey, this didn't work for me because of this, this, and this. Because not everything that's gonna work for me is gonna work for you. But if you share that information back, and if it's like, this is a community, so if you share that information or if you leave it in my comments, don't be afraid that I'm gonna be like, oh, well, you're lying. Because no, maybe your experience with a product is gonna be what someone else's experience is, and they know like, oh, I have that same problem and that product might not work for me. So we can all save each other some money or time or something like that if we all just kind of work together and we can find products that have, you know, really good chances of working for a lot of people, or if you have a particular issue, you know what I mean? So don't be afraid to leave your feedback if a product that I recommended didn't work for you. I'm not gonna be mad or think you're lying or think you're trying to be rude on my channel or anything like that. This, like I said, it's a community, so we need to like give each other feedback on stuff, and I always find that very helpful to me, because when I am talking about it like the mascara, I can say, hey, if you have really stubborn lashes that don't hold a curl, this isn't going to be a mascara for you. But you know, I can give that feedback. So if you're someone out there who has that same problem, you can take that and know that that mascara might not be for you. So I just want to encourage you guys always to feel like you can let me know on some products and stuff if you have feedback. So anyways, that is my Friday favorites and flops. As always, please leave your favorites down below. I should just say Friday favorites because I did not have a flop this week. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. And I will see you all in the next video. Mwah.